pleasant good evening to everybody as you join us at Old St. Patrick's for our first ever cooking demo. This is my first cooking demo, but it's not my first time being the Grand Marshal of a parade that never happened. Okay, so I brought my sash with me today because I, quite frankly, I haven't really been able to wear it now for 2 years. So I was asked to be the Grand Marshal last year in 2020, no parade. 2021, no parade. Two-time loser, maybe 2022, I put the question mark. Maybe third time's a charm, you know? But tonight, we're gonna have some fun and learn how to celebrate St. Patrick's Day in a unique way. And as we're doing this and having some fun, also remember that we're doing this for a purpose and for a cause. Thank you first and foremost for your great generosity. If it wasn't for you, for the people of St. Pat's, always your generosity, we wouldn't be able to do things like this. And we are going to make a difference, and we're gonna feed hopefully a couple thousand people on St. Patrick's Day on March 17th. We are going to supply meals at many of our shelters in and around Old St. Patrick's and the downtown area. So thank you so very, very much for that. Now, the team didn't think that I could handle this on my own, and they're smart people because I can't. I really don't know how to cook. So we had to bring in some chefs. We're gonna have some entertainment. We're gonna have some music. And listen, I know many of you got these nice, what do you call these things? This is called an apron. It's called an apron. Obviously, you know, I don't wear one too often. And I also wanna thank in a special way, Sheila and Honor, because if it wasn't for Sheila and Honor from our team, we wouldn't have done this creative thing. So let's get cooking. You know, I'm told that if you're gonna be in a kitchen and you're gonna be cooking stuff, you need to have a little, you know, a little liquid by the side, you know? You gotta keep keep taking care of the thirst. So, what better drink to have than a Guinness? And we have with us Jimmy Callahan. Jimmy's one of the senior ambassadors from the Guinness Company. And Jimmy is gonna help us learn how to pour the perfect Guinness. So grab a drink, get comfortable, relax, just have some fun tonight. And let's first welcome Jimmy Callahan.
Well, thank you, Father. I have been tested, so I'm good.
You're good in what way? You've been tested what way?
Tested
100%. Devil 100%, 100% or what?
Angels? I've been tested by the devil. I tried, forgive me, Father, it's been several years since my last confession.
Okay, that's fine. We'll do that after the first Guinness. Now, all right. Do you mind? I've got a lot. I'm like... I'm a mask fiend. Which one do you want?
I love the Celtic design of the green one there.
This one here?
Yeah, I love that one.
All right. I just want to, you know, we're going to have a responsible kitchen here. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
All right. Good.
Thank you for having us. We're grateful to be a part of it. And I don't think you're a two-time loser. I think you're a two-time winner because how many other Grand Marshals have been the Grand Marshal virtually like 3 years in a row?
That's true. That's true. Nobody's going to break my record.
No, just a positive reinforcement. Think of yourself as a winner, okay?
Okay, thank you.
So
thank you.
But
look at this loser sash, though.
No,
we had to
stick
this out, you know what I'm saying?
That's ingenuity. That's creativity, and you know, you're rolling with the times. So. So speaking of rolling with the times, Guinness has been around since 1759, rolling with the times for 260 years. And most people know of us for that creamy pint of stout at the bar, which unfortunately, the past couple of St. Patrick's Day, we've not been able to get. Through the magic of, well, it's not magic, it's science. Through science, we've been able to actually get the same pint that you get at the bar at home. So if you're not able to celebrate with friends and family out and about on St. Patrick's Day on Parade Day or on the actual St. Patrick's Day, you can still celebrate with a pint of Guinness at home through the magic of this little guy called the Widget. So yes, I do.
I didn't know you were a magician. I thought you were like a, you know.
Well, did you see this come out of my pocket? So this was invented in 1988. And so it's like a ping pong ball. And it's hollow. There's a hole inside. Sure. And when you crack it open, the Widget tornadoes around inside of the can. And that friction draws the gas outside of the beer. And then you get that same creamy pint that that you would at the bar. So what you want to do is have a glass handy.
Yeah.
You're going to pop open the tab. Don't be gingerly about it. You want to really aggressively pop it open. Fast. Yep. You can hear. You did great. You can hear the Widget do its thing. Now, what you want to do is gently, 45-degree angle, pour it down the side of the glass.
What's 45 degrees? Like that. Okay. Sorry.
Just mirror me, Father. Just mirror me. And so 45 degree angle. Mm-hmm. And what you're going to do is pour the Guinness down the side of the glass and let
Am
the...
Am I doing okay? Am I doing all right?
You're doing perfect. Perfect.
I get
and
nervous with
all
this
the thing. Way to the tip top. Don't be nervous. We're all Look friends here.
Look at this.
Nice. And so Look now what this. You have is that classic surge and settle, as we call it. It looks like the bubbles are falling down the side of the glass, but in actuality, the bubbles in the middle are rising faster because there's no friction, uh-huh. and they're drawing the bubbles down the side, up and under, into the middle Got to it. Form that creamy pint. But you can actually float Guinness over another beer, like our Harp or a Smittix, if you want to make a half and half.
Smittix, yeah, I like that one, yeah.
And so people will kind of be like turned off by it because the color okay. or because of that head, that creamy head, but okay. it's just nitrogen bubbles. So those nitrogen bubbles, they don't burst in your tongue when you drink them, like CO2 bubbles.
Okay.
And so it gives you the illusion of thickness or heaviness, but it's really just cream. Think of it as cream. Okay, so what you want to do okay. is block the foam with your upper lip and draw the beer from underneath in order to get the mixture of the bitterness of the cream and the sweetness of the malt and roastiness and chalkiness of the beer. It's everything you can taste on your tongue except for saltiness, which is why Guinness and seafood is such a great pairing, because you get the saltiness from
That'll the... That'll go good with the haddock.
Exactly.
The
so...
haddock cake. How about it? Look at this.
Might,
I look
might
like
wanna,
I'm holding a chalice,
you might,
doesn't it? Huh? Doesn't it? I think
we
in the choir. Be in the choir. Jimmy, you'd be great in the choir.
I just have to talk to my wife first. So I think we should cheers and celebrate St. Patrick's Day. This is going
to
sound off-putting, but it's going
it'll make
sense at the end.
Go ahead.
Here's to stealing, cheating, fighting, and drinking. If you steal, may you steal the heart of another. If you cheat, may you cheat death. If you fight, may you fight for your brother. And if you drink, may you drink with me.
Beautiful. Yeah. Well, you should write the homily for this Sunday. Thank you.
I'll be
Thank
there.
Thank you, brother. Cheers.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Sláinte. Gotta get the mustache.
Yep, you got the mustache.
Good. All right. Let's enjoy. Let's have a great evening, everybody.
Hi, everyone. I'm Carrie McClowery. I'm your 2020 and 2021 Chicago St. Patrick's Day Parade Irish Queen. Let me introduce the girls on court.
Kathleen Murphy,
Kelly Layden,
Casey Doherty. Unfortunately, we can't get together this year for a parade, but that doesn't mean we can't still celebrate from the safety of our homes. Join us on March 13th for a virtual parade. I want to thank you all for helping Old St. Pat's mission in feeding the homeless. We hope you all enjoy your delicious Irish meal tonight. We hope to see you on March 13th.
Happy St. Patrick's Day!
Introducing Chef Chris from The Gauge, who will show us how to make a smoked haddock cake.
Welcome back, everybody. And I hope you've been enjoying this tremendous show that we're putting on today. Thanks to Guinness. That was so much fun with Jimmy to learn about Guinness and how to pour the perfect Guinness. I hope I've mastered that. And likewise, too, thanks to our queen and the court. And lo and behold, who has arrived but the crown herself. And so I'm just delighted that my pal, Carrie McClowery, is here. She, like myself, last year we shared this great honor. I told Carrie, listen, we're two-time losers here, right? 2020 and 2021. So 2022 might be the charm. You never know.
Exactly.
But she's just great. And I'm just so honored to be here with Carrie. And likewise, too, with Chef Chris from The Gauge.
Nice.
And The Gauge is a great place on Michigan Avenue here in Chicago. Thanks for being here, buddy.
No, thank you. Thanks for having me. And very simple. What we're going to do today is I'm actually going to take the afternoon off. Okay. I'll be your assistant. We have smoked haddock here. We're actually going to pull the haddock. So just going to shred it with our hands. I would recommend probably putting some gloves on. If you go home on the red line, the cats will follow you all the way, just so you know. So I would say put the gloves on right now. I can help you guys shred that, and then we'll kind of get going from
Sounds
there
good.
On out.
Sounds
very
good.
Very
put
simple.
Our aprons on?
Oh, I forgot. Oh. Yes, of course.
I came prepared.
Get those aprons on. We just wanted to show off our sashes because nobody else can see them, you know? No parade, you know?
Did they give you a mulligan? They let you
this
do it again?
This was the mulligan.
Oh,
sure.
Oh, there has to be a double rule. I don't know. much like crab cakes out of New England coast or anything like that, you want to come shred it down a little bit. Not too much so you don't know that there's a fish cake there. But haddock has just a wonderful clean flavor.
Do you want me to do anything here?
Yeah, I'd say just take this one and go ahead and shred it through, and then we'll take yours and shred yours through. I'll help you with yours.
When
and
you
we'll
say shred it through, just
so
kind of
basically
pull it apart.
What you're going to do is kind of rub it through your fingers. All right, looking come good. Along. You're good.
Queenie,
you're good.
How's it going over there, Queenie? Doing all right or what?
I got it. Uh-huh.
I think right. She's
all right, Your Highness.
There you go. So again, kind of flaked out very nicely. Mm-hmm. You can see where it kind of is like the basis to what you're going to do. So eggs first. Let's do the eggs. All right. Who wants to do the one hand crack? Now this is how I wooed my wife.
Oh yeah. Oh,
wow. Now it's up
don't
to you.
Think I can do that. You got it. Come on.
Nothing to that. Nothing to it, Queenie. All right.
Here you go, Father.
Thank you.
All right. So everything from here to your right, throw it in the bowl. Here to your right, throw it in the bowl.
Okay.
All right. Nice. You can take your spoons if it starts to stick, and we'll go from there.
Sweet.
All right.
This is easy.
Now, what is
I know.
This?
So we have some raw yellow onions.
Spice?
Yes. And one of my favorite is caraway. That's in your hand right there. So caraway gives it that wonderful rye flavor, that really nice... sweetness to it. You have some thyme there. Father, you have some
I got
mayonnaise.
Some thyme, yeah. And what's this?
So we just have standard mayonnaise.
A little mayo.
Yep. So okay. That's going to act as a binder a little bit as well.
Panko?
Panko. So yes, we are using panko.
Look at you, panko.
Traditionally, you just use stale bread from the day before, anything like that. And then mashed potatoes. Again, if you have family over the night before St. Patrick's Day, so you put you put potatoes on the table.
Parsley?
Maybe with corned beef. Yes, says some parsley.
Oh, look at you. I didn't know what that one was.
I don't need to be here anymore. This is perfect. All right. And then the last but not least, you have your onions and you have your potatoes and mayonnaise. Take your large spoons. We'll put down our small spoons. And basically what you're going to do is you're going to mash it through with your spoon and kind of fold it together. Mash and fold. Why you're not using a whisk, per se, is you don't want to overdevelop the mashed potatoes.
Okay. Oh. It probably would be helpful if you keep it in the bowl, too, huh?
Nah,
okay.
You know.
Sorry, don't look anybody. Okay,
good. We look good here, guys. This looks great.
Look
so you're well mixed through. So, normally, when you would be doing this at home, you put it in the refrigerator for about an hour or so, it kind of all just relaxes together and kind of
chills out.
What I usually like to do is I'll use my spoon to put it into a pan freeform, and then I'll just kind of pat it down. So, if we can do that now... I'll show you guys real quickly. I'll just basically start it into a saute pan, and then we'll do our one-hand flip because it's a nice loose mixture. It's not a very thick, heavy, cakey mixture, so it's not going to want to really lean on that spatula very well for you. It wants to fall apart. That's how you know you've made it right. So you have to master the one-hand flip. We put it down in the oven, cook it for 7 minutes, and we're done. So it'll take around a minute to get to temperature. So what we can do in the meantime, before we do this, we can kind of, we can mix together a little salad that's going to go on top of that. All right, so separate the two bowls. What we're going to do is we're going to take apart the endive, which you can use any greens that you really want.
Endive.
What is endive?
So endive is in the chicory family.
What's a chicory?
I know. bitter greens. So basically, frisée. Nope. Radicchio.
I know lettuce.
Ridiculous?
Kind of. Well, yeah, try a piece, I guess, would be the best way to explain it to you.
Which one is
so
it?
So the endive is the white. My apologies.
This one?
Yep.
This is the endive?
Yeah, so just pull a leaf off.
All right, this one was off, so just...
I've had a...
Cheers.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yummy.
Crisp, a little bit of bitterness, mostly has a fresh watery flavor.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, I feel like fresh water, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Good stuff.
Very good. So actually, we're up to temperature now in our pan, so we can take our bowls back.
Great.
While you're munching on your endive. We'll come back to that in just a moment.
So you want us to bring these?
Yes, please
here?
Take your bowl with you.
Okay.
Take the tip of your spoon and dip it into your pan. Yep. And then you pull it up.
We're gonna put this. Oh, just put it down like this.
Yeah, put it down. So then you know you're not gonna splash, and you pull it up.
Okay.
So put the spoon down, turn it like this, pull straight up. And that way, you don't walk away with 3-degree burns.
Yeah. I've
done it before, yeah. So, I've done it a million times. And then what I like to do is basically just kind of pat it down to a cake form. We let this sit for a moment. I like to take my little handy-dandy spatula, and I'm going to press you down for me just a little bit.
Okay.
This usually takes about 4 minutes on one side. In fact, we have enough time now to actually make the salad and come back.
Should we go back to the salad? All right. Instead of eating it, now we'll make it, huh? Nobody wants to do now.
It's very simple. Just pull everything apart, put it in another bowl, put a little oil over the top.
Okay.
Boom.
Just the, I forget the name of this one, but we pull this one apart?
Yeah, just pull that one apart.
Okay. Is that like the base or something?
Well, yeah, you can make it. So what I
about that base?
I'll show you. Is
oh my gosh,
I love it. Is so I basically formed all the watercress and the gherkins inside of there like a little boat.
Oh, okay.
Now you can do whatever you want. You can free form it. You can just throw it out. You can put it on the side.
It's kind of reminding me of bunny ears.
Yeah, of course.
Perfect.
Easter's coming up.
It is coming up. Actually, that's great. I'll be honest with you. I would just serve that on the side. It's so pretty.
Yeah.
I'd serve that as the main course.
You may as well.
Now, these are just pickles, right?
Yeah, those are just pickles. You can use any type of pickles you'd like. I like them with it. It cuts the richness of the smoked fish.
Okay.
Okay. So, I pulled you guys off. You're about ready to flip.
You're going to flip without the spatula?
Yeah.
Wow.
So, flip it, and then basically you come back with your spatula.
I see this.
And you form it back through. Up. Over.
Nice.
Queen of the kitchen.
Nice! Very nice.
Got it.
Perfect, perfect, perfect. So, yours is better than mine now. Sorry, Father. Ruined yours for the day. So we get a little bit more heat back on it, and then we're gonna throw it down in the oven 7 minutes, and we're good to go.
Really? Yeah. So this goes then in the oven?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, we go to cook that egg through to basically continue that bind.
In this pan?
Yep, so what we'll do, so I'll take, if you don't mind.
Please. Go for it.
Put it down below. And if you don't mind, I'll be your assistant. Put it down below. Yep. So, 7 minutes. You can pour yourself a Guinness, relax.
I like that idea.
Time is up. We're hungry.
Bring it out of the oven, please.
We're ready to eat.
I'm hungry.
Well, yeah, it's been 7 minutes.
Can we get a job over at the... We'd want us, I would imagine,
perfectly.
Right?
Yeah,
we'd have fun
in
the kitchen.
Or the bar.
Or the bar. Now you're talking.
All right. I'm going to pass them along to you guys. Here you go. Careful. Okay. It's nice and hot.
Nice. Thanks. Oh, be careful.
Go.
All right. Nice.
So, you can just slide it right on off, or this is... Look at you. Done. Look at that. Could not be outdone. That was actually a wonderful flip. Look at that.
Look at that. It's still cooking.
Oh, man. I think he's going to win this one.
Look at this.
So, yeah. There's two things you can do, or you can do actually what you guys did here.
Is basically your hand sweating?
Yes.
Mine is now.
Really hot.
Get these hot hands away from you guys. I'm concerned for your safety. All right.
Let's eat some haddock. So what do we do now, chef?
Well, I mean, like any good chef, I take good direction. So I would say if you're going to do this at home, do exactly what you two did. This is wonderful to serve a side of a nice spicy horseradish
mustard.
But
if you're going to serve this at the Gage, though, you want this to look real pretty on top.
Yeah, if I'm serving this at the Gage, then basically I would take this.
Serve this at the Gage, you wouldn't have us helping, I don't
just
think.
Just do a nice little...
So this is a,
of that.
A mustard?
It's a horseradish mustard.
Horseradish mustard. Mm-hmm. Oh, that looks delicious.
All right, and then I would build my salad on top of that. So just take one, two, and three. Then you're going to take your watercress, because it's pretty.
I got to learn what they are, watercress. Okay.
Yeah. So watercress actually...
You put them three together, chef?
Yeah, so I'll do three together. Go ahead, and then we'll do...
Watercress in there?
Okay. Yeah, a little watercress in there. Done.
Go. Cute.
Yeah, it's adorable.
Nice.
Voila.
Yeah, I got yours.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Look at this.
That's
beautiful. Voila. Perfect. That's all I got.
Cheers.
Cheers. Let's eat. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
This is awesome. You're the best. Well, listen, coming up next, enjoy these beautiful sounds of the great Catherine O'Connell. She's going to teach me how to do soda bread later on. But Catherine, along with Jimmy Moore, just two of the greatest Irish musicians in Chicago. So enjoy these beautiful sounds and continue to enjoy the program.
As I went walking one morning in May, I met with some travelers in an old country lane. One was an old man, the second a maid. And the third was a young boy who smiled as he said, with the wind in the willows and the birds in the sky, there's a bright sun to warm us wherever we lie. We have bread and fishes and a jug of red wine to share on our journey with all of mankind. I asked them to tell me their name and their place, that I might remember their kindness and grace. My name is Joseph, this is Mary, my wife, and this is our young son, who is our delight. With the wind in the willows and the birds in the sky, there's a bright sun to warm us wherever we lie. We have bread and fishes and a jug of red wine to share on our journey with all of mankind. So sadly I left them in that old country lane, for I knew I might never see them again. One was an old man, the second a maid, and the third was young Jesus, who smiled as he said, with the wind in the willows and the birds in the sky, there's a bright sun to warm us wherever we lie. We travel people how they can be free. We travel the whole world by land and by sea to tell all God's people how they can. Now 'twas there I learned reading and writing, at Ballymartin where I went to school. It was there I learned howling and fighting from my schoolmaster, Mr. O'Toole. Him and me, we had many a scrimmage, and devil a copy I wrote, and I lathered him with my shillelagh for he tread tail of my mush 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 turlayadi, my mush 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 turlaye. Sure I lathered him with my shillelagh for he tread on the tail of my coat. Now an elegant hand I was courting, for lessons I took in the art, until Cupid that blackguard came sporting, an arrow drove straight through my heart. Now Miss O'Connor, she lived just for an insme, tender lines to her I wrote, and if you dare say a black word against her, I'll tread on the tail of your mush 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 turlayadi, You're a mush, mush, mush to rely. If you dare say a black word against her, I'll tread on the tail of your coat. Now a bog trotter named Mickey Mulvaney, he tried for to steal her away. For he had money and I hadn't any, so a challenge I sent him one day. The next morning we met at Kilterry, and the Shannon we crossed in a boat. And I lathered him with my shillelagh, for he tread on the tail of my mush, mush, mush to rely-addy. My mush, mush, mush to rely. Sure, I lathered him with my shillelagh, for he tread on the tail of my coat. Now my fame spread throughout all the nation. They came just to gaze upon me, and they all said without hesitation, "I hear a fighting man, McGee, McGee." So I whipped all the Finnegan faction, and I beat all the Hurleys afloat. And if you're in for a row or a ruction, just tread on the tail of my mush, mush, mush to rely-addy. My mush, mush, mush to rely. If you're in for a row or a ruction, just tread on the tail of my coat.
Introducing Chef Damo from the Kerryman, who will show us how to make the ultimate corned beef and cabbage.
Welcome, welcome, Damo. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I love that voice of Cullum, you know, authentic Irish voice. You kind of sound Irish too.
Yeah, I'm from Limerick.
Limerick,
I've been here a long time, but try to keep on to the accent, you know.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Yeah. Well, it's fun that you guys are here and from the Kerryman, and I'm here with my pal Skye. Skye and I work together here at Old St. Pat's, and we've been trying to learn things, right? That's our new thing now, cooking.
Good.
Right, this is our new thing.
Well, you've got a lovely kitchen here, so you should be cooking.
Thank you, yeah. This is a nice kitchen, but corned beef. Tell us about corned beef. Everybody thinks it's Irish, but you told me it's not Irish, really.
Well, that's a secret that we're not supposed to be telling anybody, but it is an Irish-American dish.
Mum's the word.
So when the famine happened in Ireland in the late 1800s, and we moved to America, beef actually was cheaper than pork. We have a very similar dish in Ireland called bacon and cabbage. So to save some money, we ended up using beef brisket. Cabbage was always cheap, so we wanted to try and bring some taste of Ireland to New York.
Okay.
So as you can see here, this is a raw beef brisket that we've brined for 33 days in 33 herbs and spices.
Wow. That's a big piece of brisket there, brother.
So that's a restaurant style. You can buy little pieces in your local grocery as well. But we cook this then for about 8 to 12 hours on the stove. We boil it, and then this is what you end up with. After you trim all the fat off, you're left with nice, clean briskets.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. I love corned beef. You ever had corned beef?
Yeah, no, I'm not a beef eater.
It's delicious.
You might try this, though, Skye.
I might try it.
Yeah.
Try it in March.
We'll bring this to the staff for lunch.
Okay.
I mean, look at the size. We could feed the staff and
exactly,
the rest of Chicago.
A ton of people.
For sure, for sure.
Yeah.
All right, tell us, how do we do this?
So then, after we've trimmed all our fat off, we end up re-boiling it again in the brine that we just used. Then while we're brining this again, we saute our cabbage and our carrots and our potatoes that are already pre-cooked in a compound butter.
Say that again, what are these?
These are Yukon Gold potatoes.
I like how you say potatoes.
Yeah,
I like
exactly.
That.
Or like, that's the fancy word. We call them spuds.
Spuds.
Yeah. So anyway, once we've all that done, we have a sauce that my grandmother came up with.
Oh.
R.I.P. Lord of Mercy, blah, 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 you know.
Yeah.
So I'm going to make a sauce today for the corned beef and cabbage. It's called a parsley cream sauce.
Okay.
So basically, we start off with Kerrygold butter. You have to get salted Kerrygold butter.
That's good stuff. I like Kerrygold.
That goes into the pan like that.
Yeah.
Leave that over there. So I like to use Spanish onion.
Spanish onion?
We can't get Irish onions over here for some reason, so I like to just
it's very inclusive.
There you go. So then we're going to add a little bit of heavy cream. A lot. Okay. Everything's good with cream.
Yeah.
A little bit of parsley. And then, of course, because it's green, it has to be Irish.
Of course.
And obviously seasoning, a little salt and pepper. And then all you want to do is bring it to a simmer on the stovetop. You're just going to simmer that.
So that's a stove? Is that what
that
this
is? That is a stove. That is a fancy stove. But it really looks nice.
Yeah,
you should be using it more often.
My stove at home doesn't look like this.
So you just want to bring that to heat. You're going to reduce it just a tiny little bit.
Uh-huh.
And then you're just going to pour it right over the corned beef.
How many pounds of corned beef do you guys go through during St. Patrick's
Day? So the week of Paddy's Day, we order in 800 pounds of this.
800 pounds?
Yeah, so by the time we've trimmed it all down, it's down to about 600.
So give me an idea, what do you think that weighs there?
That's about a 20 pounder.
That's a 20 pounder, mm-hmm. So 800 pounds.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. It's
wow.
A lot of meat.
That's a lot of meat.
But by the time we're ended, like the day after Paddy's Day, my muscles are like this size. You know, absolutely huge.
Got it.
So our sauce should be ready. So as you see, the sauce doesn't take that long. The last thing you want to do is burn it, so you want to keep it on a low heat.
Okay. Yeah.
Just make sure that butter's melted all the way through and you reduce it just a tad, just so it thickens up a little bit, you know?
Okay.
And you're going to bring it over here.
Beautiful.
And you want to get some of that butter in there. Get some onions.
That look good.
It smells delectable.
Mm-hmm.
And nice and easy.
Demo, that's a thing of beauty.
So this is the one we're going to be serving at the restaurant for about 2 weeks in March. But we're also going to be doing a package deal. So, you know, with everything going on this year and last year, we said a lot of people aren't going to be comfortable going to the restaurant. So
yeah.
We wanted to put some sort of a package together. So this is what we have here.
Oh, nice.
So this is this feeds a family of four. So you've got your corned beef, your potatoes, your cabbage, the parsley cream sauce. You get four potato and leek soups and four slices of soda bread. Grandma's recipe again.
You guys got great food over there at the Curry Man. I love that.
Yeah, that's
I haven't had this yet, but I've had the shepherd's pie over there. Mm-hmm. Delicious, delicious.
So, Chef, how do you carve this for someone who doesn't know how to carve corned beef?
So there's a right way and a wrong way.
Okay.
So if you pick up your brisket and you check the underneath or on one of the sides, you'll see there's lines going through it.
Yes.
You always want to cut against the grain.
Cut against the grain.
Don't cut with the grain because it'll make the meat tough. Cut against the grain, it'll make it tender.
Really? So the way you cut it.
Can I show you how to do it?
Please.
Do you mind?
Absolutely.
Perfect.
Absolutely.
Father, I need a plate. Absolutely. Good man yourself.
Here you are now.
You're the best. Thank you.
Thank you.
So you can see the lines are going this way.
Yes.
So you're going to cut this way. So basically, you know, it all depends on how hungry you are.
I'm starving.
You want to go take that first piece off and see how it's so nice, nice and tender here. And then, again, you can decide how thick you want it. But I like to do nice and thin.
Oh, is that beautiful?
And then you just keep carving.
Beautiful.
And there
silly
you go.
Me, now I would have cut.
You would have cut the other one.
I would have cut the other one.
Yep.
But I'm not real smart.
Well, then it would have been tough.
Everyone would have been tough.
Nobody would have been happy.
Well, Chef, this was terrific.
Good.
Wow. Yeah, how about it? Let's go.
I would have.
Let's go to the Curry Man.
You wanna start?
Let's start now.
Absolutely.
Let's eat.
I'm ready.
Grab the plates.
Whenever you're ready.
Let's have fun.
Okay.
Dinner at Father's house tonight. Yeah.
Oh, man. Well, thanks a lot.
No, thank you.
Well, listen, we got more great stuff coming up. And Pat McGann, my funny man friend, is going to entertain us. And then we'll hear from the beautiful sounds of Patricia Tracy, one of the greatest violin players, fiddler players of Ireland. And so enjoy the rest of this beautiful show.
Hello, everyone at Old St. Pat's. What a night. You know, I've always been confused by St. Patrick's Day falling in the middle of Lent. It's quite the hurdle, right? Because we give up drinking, we give up meat, and then here comes the corned beef and beer. We need a dispensation. Let's hook it up. Right, Father Hurley? I hope he's handing out some dispensations this year. You know, there's one thing I've learned being Catholic is there's always a loophole. Find the loophole and adjust, all right? I mean, St. Patrick being the patron saint of spring break, it's hard. Anyway, sorry that we can't all be together. I know you guys usually get together in person. Soon, there's light ahead. Got this vaccine. I want the vaccine, by the way. Some people don't want to get vaccinated. Put it in my eyeball. Let's go. Don't want to get vaccinated. You know how you sell that? Offer it in flavors. Like, you're not getting the vaccine. You know they have it in ranch? They have it in ranch? My parents got vaccinated. They're in their 70s, which a little selfish, right? It's like, how about your son? What's up with the guys just... Is that the nightclub scene, by the way? Just people in their 70s and 80s? Are they just owning the club scene? You got Johnny Mathis with a residency at Tao. You're going to head over to Studio Paris Dance Club? Dick Biondi's there. Cascade's not DJing this week. It's Dick Biondi, straight from Jack Thompson Oldsmobile. Anyway, I want to say happy St. Patrick's Day. My name is Patrick, and it's a great day. And Old St. Pat's, you guys are the absolute best. I hope everyone has a great night and enjoy that Irish food. Bye.
Grateful to Old St. Pat's community for their generous donations to this program, and Corcorans are so proud to work towards helping take a dent out of hunger in our community. Cheers, St. Pat's. Sláinte.
Introducing Catherine O'Connell, who will be making her nearly famous soda bread.
It is a great honor to be here for our next segment with my dear friend, my sister, the voice of Chicago, the Irish voice with Catherine. But first, a thanks to the Vaughn Group. Thanks for the beautiful and generous donation that you're making to make sure that we feed people. And again, this is to have some fun, but it's also to make sure people who go hungry on St. Patrick's Day can enjoy something to eat. So thanks to them. Thanks to Patricia and to Mark for just beautiful music. And again, speaking of beautiful music, here we are, here we go. From music to soda bread.
all right, so this right. soda bread, although I'd love to say it was my mother's, it wasn't. Margaret Kelly first started me on soda bread, and then I adapted it a little bit more because I wanted to use my KitchenAid mixer. So I measured out everything, all the dry ingredients.
The dry ingredients.
Yes, that's the sugar, the flour, baking soda, baking powder, and salt.
Got it.
And then
ingredients. This doesn't look dry.
They're measured into the bowl, Tom.
Oh, I get it. Okay. All right. Yeah. Stick with you.
Now put the head down.
This?
Yep.
I'm actually going to do this?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
No, there's two mixers here for me to operate and you to watch. It's
You're
not
very
a spectator
talented.
Sport.
You sing, you cook, you can operate two of these.
All right. So you want?
Yeah. What do I do?
You have to turn it on, go to that side, and just on two.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
One. That's two, I think.
Mm-hmm. And then all we're doing is kind of mixing these. You're supposed to sift them, but I'm too lazy for that. So
I'll turn it up a little bit?
I'm going to turn it up a little bit.
Was that too fast?
Well, if you're seeing clouds, yes. and then I'm going to turn it off, and then I cut the butter into cubes, so now we're going to put this in there and break up that butter so that it looks like...
How do you get this thing up? Oh, like this here? No.
Oh, you locked it. Okay, just lift it.
Oh, there it is. Okay. Now, what do I do with this butter? Put it in?
You just dump it in there.
All right.
Put the head back down. Put it on
that
two
easy
again.
Enough. Yeah. That's easy enough.
Well, yeah, because I did it for you.
Put it down. Two, all right.
Yeah. Just so we get it, and then so we're going to try to get it. Yeah.
This is easy. Oh, I've turned it up?
I'm going to turn it up a little more. Break up that butter until it's like pebbles.
I think
you don't want any big cubes left, you know?
No big cubes?
Let's just see. I still have cubes in mine. How's yours?
I don't know.
We'll stop it and look.
I'll turn it up a little bit.
Yeah. When all else fails, turn it up.
All right.
Okay, this is pretty good. Now, I'm going to change beaters. Let me see yours.
How's that?
Oh, yeah, yours is great.
Oh, great, of course. Okay, now what am I going to do?
You push this in.
Push this in?
And turn it. Push it up and turn it. There you go. Oh. And whack it on the side there.
Judas Priest, how do I get this off? Okay, there you go.
Yeah. Okay. Toss your raisins in there.
These are
yours
raisins.
Are currants.
Oh, these are currants?
Yeah, see,
what does that
look
mean?
At,
yours are
tinier.
Past? Yours are past, these are current. Okay, got it.
Exactly. But mine are old and fat.
You said it, not me. Now put
all
these
right.
in.
And then you just toss them in there.
Okay.
And we're switching
clean.
To
Hands
this.
They're clean, everybody. They're clean.
Yeah, what's and that? Then we're switching to this.
What's
it's the
that?
Paddle.
It's the what?
The paddle.
The paddle.
That's
I got that a lot as a kid.
Oh, I doubt that. Weren't you always sanctified?
No.
All right, that's on. Just leave it alone. Now put it down and turn it on to two again.
Two.
So all we're doing is just kind of...
we're mixing it.
Coating the raisins.
Oh, we're coating the raisins and the currants.
Right.
The past
so that
and the
they,
present.
Right.
Okay.
And now we're going to scramble eggs. Here's
you
the
want
done.
Me to...
Stop.
Stop. Now what do you want me to do here? Break these eggs?
Yes.
How's that?
Brilliant.
Do this again.
Mm-hmm.
I had an aunt from Ireland. She used to crack it on our heads.
Oh, and that must have been fun.
That was fun. Yeah, bring your head here. Boom.
Well, that could explain things.
What do I do? Just mix it up.
Oh, it's like the Three Stooges. Yeah. It's very much like the Three Stooges. Nicely done. All right. So we're going to turn this back on again and drizzle this in here. Again, everything kind of just gets incorporated.
Wait a minute. What do I do? Turn this back on?
Yep. Good.
Mine looks better than yours.
It sure does. How does that happen? Son of a...
Easy.
Turn it off again.
I hit it off. Yeah.
Tip it up.
Okay. Take this off.
Whack it clean. Now we're going to put this dough hook on.
The deer hook?
The dough. Dough hook.
I said the deer hook. I had the dough hook. Oh. All right.
Okay. Bambi, watch out. All right, put it down.
Okay, put it down. Gently, now what?
Gently, and turn it on. Okay, and now, slowly, see how I also measured out buttermilk for you?
Oh, the buttermilk. Yeah, yeah. I was going to say, this looks pretty dry.
You're on stir.
I don't know the difference. Yeah, you said two.
I think you're on stir there. Okay, and so.
Oh, I see.
Ooh.
So what do you want me to do now?
We're going to slowly add buttermilk.
Slowly?
Yeah, this does look, you're right, this does look a little dry.
It's all right. A little buttermilk. You want it all in?
Nope. You're going to knock down the sides.
Knock down the sides?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So what we're looking for is the bread to pull away from the bowl and clean the bowl.
Mine's definitely happening. All right, am I done with this?
That looks good.
Of course. All right, Slowpoke, when you're done, you catch up to me. Now, do you want me to take this deer hook off?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay. And then are your hands clean?
No, I've been licking them the whole time. And
so you pick up the thing and you form it into a ball.
I can't get this thing off.
Oh, your spring is gone.
No, come on.
Wait, your spring is gone. There's supposed to be a spring here.
Maybe No, come on. There was no spring on there.
Yeah, there is a spring.
Mr. Spring, where are you?
Yeah, oh my gosh.
No.
KitchenAid is not going to like that.
Okay. All right, now what do I do, kid?
All right, so now you take it out, take the bowl. I would just...
With my hands?
Yeah.
Of course. Where are we going to put it? On this board here?
No, we're going to put it right
in
there.
Oh, this pan?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That I have also prepped for you.
It looks like it's kind of greasy.
Exactly right. And you form it into a ball.
Oh, good. We'll play catch.
Let me hit you in the head with this.
Kill somebody with this bread. Golly, this is gross. All right, there we go.
All right, you put it in the pan.
I'm still trying to see if the spring's in there. All right, I know what you want me to do. Put it in there?
Yeah. Nice. Don't press too hard because it's got a... Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay, we take a knife and we cut it.
We didn't even bake it. Why do you want to cut it already?
This lets the evil spirits out, Tom.
Oh,
you can
that's
bless
right.
it
I
if
forgot.
You want.
I forgot it's your family recipe.
You can bless it if you want.
Oh, look at that. Beautiful, huh?
Do you want to cut it?
Of course, I've done everything else.
You have done everything else.
Let out those evil spirits.
Go away. Get away. Go away. Fly away home. Fly away to the Hermes. All right.
Oh, isn't that beautiful?
That is.
Huh?
That's it. Now, it goes in the oven for 50 to 60 minutes. If you have a remote thermometer, it's done at 200 degrees internal temperature.
Well, that looks beautiful.
That's the way it's supposed to look.
Oh, my gosh.
So when we finish cooking yours, it's going to look just like this. I promise you.
It'll look better. I promise.
So what I normally do is break
this, all of you.
Break and take and eat?
Yes.
Okay. And then... sometimes if you just want just a quarter, because you know you're just gonna have one cup of coffee.
That's a lot of bread. that looks delicious.
There you go.
Oh, yum. And okay, can I eat it?
Now these, just so you know, these are, I put cranberries in here because I was out of raisins. Dried cranberries.
Delicious. I love the cranberries. They're a good band too. Love that.
Mm-hmm.
This is excellent. Very, very good. Follow this recipe. It's really, really good. So,
Happy St. Pat's.
Happy St. Patrick's Day. Thank you, my dear friend.
You're welcome.
Sister, this is excellent. I've never done this before. And we can give some now to the Irish Council General. We're so lucky. Kevin Byrne is with us, and Kevin's going to give us a shout out today, and just so delighted to welcome him to Chicago. He replaced the great Brian O'Brien, who went back to the homeland, and we're just lucky that Kevin is here with us. So, see you the next time. This is really good.
Dave, hello everyone. I'm Kevin Byrne, Consul General here at the Irish Consulate in Chicago. I'm very grateful to Father Hurley and everyone at Old St. Pat's for the opportunity to share the best wishes of St. Patrick's Day from the Consulate and the Irish Government. As much as anything else, St. Patrick's Day is a celebration of community, of the connections we have between each other and of the support that we can provide. And there can be no better example of this than Old St. Pat's Chef's Kitchen. Wishing the event every success and wishing you all a great evening of culinary and cultural treats. Lá féile Pádraig Sona agus a Bhfáilte Díobh Galéire.
So terrific. So grateful to our friends from Trinity Irish School of Dancing. They are just some of the best. We are so fortunate in Chicago with just some of the best Irish entertainment. So thanks to all of them, to the wonderful young ladies who were part of our show tonight. And thanks to all of you. Thanks for joining us and for cooking up and serving for a cause. So many people are going to benefit because of your generosity. And this is the spirit of St. Pat's. It's the spirit of Old St. Pat's. It is the spirit of kinship, of how we continue to
make the gospel a reality for people right here in our own city. I don't know about you, but I learned a lot. And I'm just so grateful to all those who were a part of this experience. So grateful to have learned how to make a few things. And now maybe I'll do the new member dinners. I'll be the chef for the new member dinners. Although I think a lot of folks will split if they taste my stuff. I want to thank our presenting sponsors. Thanks to our friends at Guinness, to Jimmy Callahan, who was with us today, to our friends over at the Plumbers Union, Local 130, and the St. Patrick's Day Parade Committee. They are always so good to us, and it's just so much fun to be in partnership with them. And finally, again, thanks to you for all your generosity, for making this a reality. A unique way of celebrating St. Patrick's Day indeed, but I hope you had as much fun as I did. And thanks to all of our entertainers, and thanks to all the participants. I was just so fortunate to be here with our queen, with Carrie, with my friend Sky, and Catherine O'Connell, and Chef Damo from the Carry Man, and Chef Chris from The Gauge. Just so much fun to be with them and to learn a few things. I don't know about you, but listen, I'm tired of being in this kitchen all day. So I'm gonna put down my apron and continue to show off my sash, and we'll hope for a parade someday soon, okay? But hey, listen, I gotta make sure I remembered how to do this, okay? It's the end of a day. Now remember, he said open it real quick. Oh, nice. Listen to that. All right, 45 degree angle. Not too slow, but not too fast. Let's see if I can make it look like Jimmy's. Oh, look at this. This is a thing of beauty. All right, the ball. Ball's in there, all right? All the nitro something acid in here? I don't know what he said, whatever. Who cares, it's Guinness. Got the mustache, it's good. Happy St. Patrick's Day, sláinte to all.
Your right foot out, okay? Then you're gonna put it behind, and then take three steps, front, back, front. Then you're gonna do this two more times. So you switch, jump, then kick, then put it behind, front, back, front. And then one more time, jump, kick, put it behind, front, back, front. And then for the ending, you bring your back foot from behind and do a kick, and put it behind. Okay, I think we're ready to do it a little bit faster. So let's try it to music. Thank you for learning with us. Have a happy St. Patrick's Day.